Hello, my name is Otto Scheck, and I'm a third-year radiology resident at Einstein Medical Center in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I have the pleasure of presenting a case of circumcaval ureter. Our patient is a 54-year-old male with a history of kidney stones and gallstone who presented as an outpatient with reported unintentional weight loss in the setting of recurrent biliary colic. Sagittal grayscale ultrasound image of the right kidney shows hydronephrosis, as indicated by the white arrows. Split image transverse grayscale and color Doppler ultrasound images of the right kidney show an echogenic calculus, as indicated by the yellow arrow, with corresponding twinkle artifact, as indicated by the yellow arrowhead. AP scalp view prior to IV contrast enhanced CT of the abdomen and pelvis in the excretory phase shows right proximal ureteral dilatation with an abrupt change in mid ureter caliber at the level of L3, as indicated by the white arrow. The left ureter is normal in caliber and course. The bladder is distended with contrast. There are no radiopaque calcifications along the course of the urinary tract. Axial IV contrast enhanced CT image through the abdomen in the excretory phase at the level of L3, L4 shows three contrast-filled structures representing different portions of the right ureter. The rightmost structure is the more proximal part of the ureter and is dilated, as indicated by the white arrow. The middle structure is the ureter after it has traveled superiorly back into the same axial plane, as indicated by the white arrow head. The smaller caliber leftmost structure is the continuation of the right ureter, which is now located medial to the IVC, as indicated by the white circle. Coronal IV contrast enhanced MIP CT image through the right hemiabdomen and the excretory phase shows proximal hydroureteronephrosis and normal cupping of the calyces without blunting. There is a U-shaped curve, also known as the fishhook appearance, of the right ureter at the mid-lumbar level, as indicated by the white arrow. The final diagnosis is type 1 circumcaval ureter. Remember, with type 1 circumcaval ureter, contrast-enhanced CT and intravenous urography will show right-sided hydronephrosis and dilatation of the proximal right ureter to the level of L3. Medial deviation of the right ureter at this level, as it passes posterior to the IVC, gives rise to the fishhook or reversed S appearance of the ureter. The distal course of the right ureter is normal. Because this is an anomaly of the IVC, the left ureter is not affected. The differential diagnosis includes, number one, ureterovesical obstruction, which may be due to etiologies including retroperitoneal fibrosis or extrinsic compression by a mass. However, no such imaging features were identified on CT. The differential diagnosis also includes ureteral cancer or mass, but these were not identified on imaging. Finally, the differential diagnosis includes nephrolithiasis. While the patient has a history of kidney stones with multiple non-obstructing stones seen on ultrasound, no obstructing stone was visualized, and furthermore, this diagnosis is incomplete. To summarize, while the term circumcaval succinctly describes the anatomic location of the ureter, the obstruction is not related to anomalous development of the ureter. Instead, it is the result of anomalous development of the infrarenal inferior vena cava after the right posterior carinal vein fails to atrophy. There are two types. The first type causes the classic fishhook appearance at the level of the third or fourth lumbar vertebra and will cause hydronephrosis approximately 50% of the time. The second is rarer and causes obstruction at the level of the renal pelvis with classic sickle-shaped appearance of the ureter. Symptoms include recurrent infection or stone formation. Treatment is surgical for patients exhibiting symptoms related to urine stasis in the setting of chronic hydronephrosis due to obstruction. And with that, I hope you enjoyed this presentation. Thank you for watching.